Hello everyone, welcome to Reptile Ridge and my yard. If you've watched any of my videos in the past on anoles, you already know how charming and intelligent they are. They can also utilize some pretty unique items for shelter. Old lawn equipment and furniture being some of the most popular for the anoles to claim as their own. I'm not sure, but I think this young anole could be the one that we came to know as Spot. It's been a long time since I've seen any of the grown adult male anoles, but today I found this large male living in the brush along the tree line. This is where I'd last seen Phoenix, Orion, and some of the other anoles we'd kept up with back in the spring. Sadly, contact with those anoles was lost back in the summer, when temperatures reached record highs. The extreme heat may have killed some of them off. Anoles don't seem to be able to handle the extreme heat as well as other species of reptiles do. Now, this footage was shot back in December of 2009. During this time, the temperatures ranged anywhere from 70 to 80 degrees during the day. But at night, they could plummet to below freezing. Typical weather for the Gulf Coast in December. In order for these small reptiles to survive all these weather extremes, they have to come up with some pretty smart ways to escape the elements. Out here behind the dog yard, I've discovered a group of anoles. I've deemed them the Garden Club. Living alongside them, this young Fencie. The Fencie jumps into the cover. Nearby, another anole appears. We've seen this one before. I believe it's a female. And she loves this piece of gardening equipment. It's an old fertilizer dispenser. It suits her just fine. She and the others stay a safe distance from the fence and well out of reach of the dogs. The small fence lizard, who I also believe to be a female, rests on the warm handle of the garden rake. It's a dark color and holds more heat. Down in the weathered cardboard boxes, another anole creeps about. This is why the old boxes full of stuff remain in my backyard. They're for the anoles, fences, and other reptiles like skinks, race runners, and some snakes. For these guys, this is the life. These junk piles are their better homes. As far as gardens go, we have 10 acres of prime forest. It's a virtual Garden of Eden for the local wildlife. Over on the north side of the tree line, around our house, I've discovered another small clan of anoles. Now, these are living in the vicinity of our electric pole. There you can see some of our pretty foliage. Sharing the territory with the anoles is another small fence lizard. The two species seem to get along quite well. As the cool winter wind blows, the anoles have to shift around in order to stay in the sunlight and out of the wind as best as they possibly can. Since it's a chilly, windy day, the anoles can do nothing but try to stay warm. Hunting is not practical, at least at this moment. The wind hinders their ability to catch prey. There are lots of them out basking, each of them trying to deal with the changes in temperatures and the amount of daylight. It's diminishing daily as winter zeroes in on us. By the way, I've named this little group of lizards the Electric Company. This is the dominant male. I'm calling him Sparky for identification purposes. Sparky keeps a close watch on his small group of females. They all look fit and hopefully will survive the winter. About 25 feet away from the Electric Company, Bill, the young male, still claims this old laptop computer and the ice cooler for his home. So far, this little setup has worked well for him. He's been here since August of 09, about 4 months. As for the female we met back in October, named Jenny, I believe this is she. Jenny has proven to be a very smart little girl. Currently, she's moved around from the tire in the front yard to higher ground, to this window in back of the house. Here, she receives more sunlight. This may be one of the best choices this little anole can make in order to make it through the hard times. I, for one, believe that anoles and other wildlife can make anyone's home or garden a much better place in more ways than one. Thanks for watching.